And invite my son, the other priests, already left. Because when one of the priests of the vicariate of Porto Catawe by the name of Father Frederick Lipaya died yesterday at 4:27 p.m. And he was just a priest for 9 months. He was active in his ministry after ordination only for 3 months, around 3 months, 4 months. And then he got sick. He stayed here in the Diocesan Pastoral Center for his medical treatment. And when eventually yesterday he died. And so I celebrated actually the Mass there at 6. Father Bernie left because he would be celebrating also another Mass. Because the body will be brought to Bonpo at midnight tonight. So we keep on praying for our priests, Father David Magana, you know, also died, and his body was brought to Tugao yesterday after the Mass. And the burial of Father David Magana will be this coming Monday, September 26th. At St. Mary's Magdalene Church in Catawe. So those are developments in our diocese that when we have really have to take into consideration, especially now the priests are well becoming older and seeking also. So we continue for the health of our priests, and well, thanks be to God. Hopefully we will have 3 ordinations this coming January. January 16th will be the ordination of Reverend James Castillo in Iraq. January 18th will be the ordination of Reverend Nelson Dumeres in Abaya. And January 20th will be the ordination of Reverend Vicente Encheta in Tinduman. And so continue praying for them that they will also persevere in their ministries. Okay, so we need priests. What is nangalisan without the priest? Nangalisan would be nothing. Bakit tayo nagko-concert dito? Ipapatay tayo ng simbahan, pero pupulang tayo ng pari. Ano yun? And so there is always the connection. And you see, the church that we're building in nangalisan is connected with the celebration actually of the year of mission, which we celebrated last year. And that is our response to the year of mission declared by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines, that at least in the Diocese of Baguio, we will be establishing mission stations. And one of them is the station in Nangalisan. So eventually, the people there will be elevated into a mission station. And there is another one in Malbo. Well, that is also being geared towards the establishment of the mission station. Another one is in Malindi Mangkayan, in the Philippines, towards the Mountain Province area. We will also be building a church there. We already bought a land for the mission station. deism. Now we're going to build the church there for the future mission station of the area. Another is in Dabapiri. We are grouping Dabapiri also to become a mission station someday. And another one in Vedal, that's in Bakun, in the Philippines also, towards the Nokosuri. So all of these are developments in our diocese. And we have to be thankful to the good Lord that there are people who have been so generous and helping us, especially the putting up of the buildings of this mission station. So thank you so much for the great help and support you have given to Nanalisan. I was surprised that even during the pandemic, the construction of the church there in Nanalisan did not stop. In other words, people were continuously contributing for the construction of the church. And I congratulate you for this evening's fundraising celebration, that at least you took the initiative headed by Father Clyde to raise funds for the construction, the people's construction of the church in Nanalisan. You know, I'm not only thinking of Nanalisan 5 years from now or 10 years from now. I'm thinking of Nanalisan 50 years from now. That is why people are surprised. Himong panagin, ganyan ang malaki ang simbahan. I'm thinking of the church 50 years from now. Kasi kung ngayon lang, ay maliit lang ang kailangan natin. Pero kung maliit lang, hindi natin alam ang potential ng lugar na yan. It is so rich in its potentiality. Maraming mga resort dyan, di ba? And then roads are being developed. And so I could see the potential of the place that eventually 50 years from now, there will be very many people who will be staying there. And we have to have a big church for that. So that explains why we have that big church being constructed now. Medyo mahirapan sa atin. It is our generation, it is our task. But eventually, that would be for our children and grandchildren who eventually will take over the place, who will replace us. And hoping and praying that they will continue our efforts in the building up of the Christian faith. And so, that is very important. Well, very important, the building up of the Christian faith. That is more challenging. Hindi lang yung building a physical, but the faith of the people, to build the faith of the people is more challenging than building a physical building like the church. Napakahirap yun. And it takes years. It takes even centuries, as the history of the church will tell us, to build and develop the faith of the Christian people. And so we pray for this then, and I thank all of you for the sacrifices, the efforts that you have done for Nanalisan. We are only starting, and it's good that we have started well. We will try to finish it well, because eventually that would be for you, for the people of Nanalisan. Kami, mga pare, maya-maya mawawala na dito. Mawawala na sa mundo. No? We come, we go. But the church there, the community of faith will remain. And who will remain there? Kayo na mga taga-Nanalisan. Kayo mo ay iiwan dyan. Okay, so that's my message for you. Continue to support our church there, the construction. please cooperate in the construction of the faith community of the area. Thank you.